Hi guys, Jordan with Motion Array, and today we're taking a look at how to save you time and help you edit faster with keyboard shortcuts. If you can edit faster in Premiere Pro, that's a big deal. The faster you complete a project, the faster you can push it out into the world. And if you're getting paid a set price for a video, you're technically getting paid more per hour. So we want to help you edit faster with our 10 favorite keyboard shortcuts for Premiere Pro. So let's just start it out with number one, the shuttle buttons, J, K, and L. These are pretty much your reverse, pause, and forward buttons respectively. But while hitting L once makes your clip play at normal speed, hitting it twice will make it play back at double speed, and then again makes it play back even faster. So if you're looking to review a project after you finish it to check to make sure there's no hidden surprises before you export, watching it at double speed can really help you save unnecessary time sitting watching it playing. Not too long ago, I had to export a 4-hour long timeline for a conference video. If I didn't know this technique, I would be absolutely livid right now. Number two, Alt or Option. If you ever wanted to work with either video or audio portions of the clip in isolation, but didn't want to go through the trouble of unlinking it, just hold the Alt or Option key while clicking and you can isolate that portion of the clip to edit. Number three, Shift Up, Shift Down. If you hold the Shift button and press either the up or down arrow keys, the video playhead will skip to the next change in audio or video on your timeline. This is really helpful if you want to immediately find the next clip after a long duration. Number four, C for the Blade tool. This is by far one of the most frequent tools I use for editing, period. No matter where I am in the edit, I will likely have to cut a piece of it somewhere. Just select the tool with C and cut away. And if you hold Shift before you make a cut, you'll cut the entire timeline top to bottom. Number five, plus and minus buttons. Next to the cut tool, this is the most frequent shortcut that I end up using. Without even having to move your mouse, hit the plus button to dive in deeper, or hit the minus button to go back out and get a bird's eye view of your timeline. Side note, hitting this button right underneath your delete key will make your timeline just big enough to see everything that you're working with. Kind of like bringing everything back to square one. Number six, the rolling edit tool. If you need to change your cut location, but you want to do it without having to readjust either of the clips individually, this is a fantastic option. Just click and drag to choose a new breaking point. Number seven, the slip tool. Is one of your video's timing just a little bit off? Hi guys, Jordan with Motion Array, and today, slip it backwards or forwards to make sure that you're right on the money. It's easy. Just hit Y and click and drag to keep your clips at the same physical place on your timeline, but move it forward or backwards in time. Number eight, Alt and Drag. There's a lot of times I find myself needing to duplicate a clip. The copy and paste method can work, but what I prefer to do is just hold Alt or Option and then click and drag your clip to a new position. Your original stays put right where it was, and the copy ends up wherever you let go of your mouse. Number nine, A and Shift A. There will be a time when you need to move a big section of clips in one direction or another, but drag selecting everything can be really frustrating depending on how full your timeline is. So hitting A will bring up the Select Everything to the Right tool, while holding Shift and hitting A will pull up the Select Everything to the Left tool. Next time you click, everything to the right or left of that mouse click will be selected. And finally, number 10, Control S to save your work. Often. This is not one of those mind-blowing realizations when you hear hit Control S to save your work, but it's one of those that if you get into the habit of saving your work every minute or so, it'll save your bacon on more than one occasion, guaranteed. If you ever have a crash, or Premiere accidentally shuts off, or just generally freaks out, you'll be glad that you have this habit baked into your workflow. Speaking of which, have you ever had a problem with Premiere Pro crashing on you? Well, if you have, we dive into how to fix those sorts of problems in this video over here. And if you want to check out our most recent upload, it's this video over here. And as always, please subscribe to our channel. If you like this video, give it a like, and even share it with a fellow video editor friend if it changed your workflow. Thank you so much for watching, and I can't wait to see you in the next video.